Hello, and welcome to the 200th episode of Let's Play Pillars of Eternity. I am the RPG Chick, and for my 200th episode, I am going to be exploring the entire, 10th floor, 10th level, level 10, of the Endless Paths of Adnua. Not sure how long it's going to be, of course. Playing blind. Blind run. Never seen before. Typically it's been between an hour and a half. Interesting.
Alright, so sure.
Starting off. Oh. Hello, Shade. Might as well just attack it here. And another Shade. It's weird how we start out in this room. And then that door. Well, they're appearing all around us. Shade, Shade, Shade. Just to see if... Well, I can also go like that. Some more might appear. Luckily, Shades aren't that tough. The only bad thing is we don't have any more camping supplies. Everyone will take pierce damage. I kinda like that. Especially since they're gonna be... coming in on us now. Let's go for that one, I guess. That is the ADS. Kinda. A dare. Knockdown. We were knocking down specters. Zoom in there. Oh boy, they're swarming Aloth here. Wizard's double. Drink that.
Yeah.
Can we be interrupted drinking? I think so. Yeah, they interrupted him drinking. Oh, there's a shadow. General healing, I'm sure we're gonna need it. Where is she? Palagina?
Following.
Oh, he took it, cool. I think so. Looks like he took it. Attack the one that's hitting you. Oh, are we like laying waste to them? Seem to be.
Following your lead.
It's just throwing a blessing, why not? She's already fighting that one. I Quite sufficient. Yes, thank you. Oh, well, that wasn't that bad. Oh, crap. I hear one of them. Those Shangri-La things. There's a crystal eater spiraling, and where that is, a mother can't be far. There's a Widowmaker spiraling. Spiderling.
Great.
Gonna die relatively quickly. Disintegrate on this thing. I don't know if we can reach that from there. We'll try. Oh, we already knocked it. Yeah, never mind. I don't know how to turn that off. Oh well.
I'm ready.
Oh yeah, she can't reach Theodas. Alright, let's disintegrate something closer. Kind of a waste. Can we do that one? Oh, chunks! Been a while since we saw chunks.
That's it.
Wait your turn, little spiders. More big spiders. Except for you. Looking at that one. Who's that, Theta? Oh, require proper key, huh? Spotted that red text by mistake. Inadvertently. Well, stop your whining, my god.
Let's see what lies this way.
Want any cheese with that wine? Then frickin' fine. Oh, something in the web. Something out of the web. Let's make sure we're all... except for our famous Kana. The intelligent but non-commonsensical fighter type, etc.
That's it!
Killed your baba. Strafing run. Boom. Boom. Hold on. He's got his fist again. Necrotic Lance on that one. Disintegrate on that one.
My eyes are peeled.
Made short work of them. Yes! Camping supplies! Hooray! Now maybe we won't have to return to the top. So this, apparently this is the spider level.
Got it.
Seem to have that feeling. And shadows. But a lot of spiders right now. Spaced pretty evenly apart as well. This is a full-fledged adult litter maker right here.
Braved out.
And we just killed it just like that.
He lost your lead.
Oh, they webbed us. We might have to use a melee. Let's see what we can do though. It's Palagina. Oh god, there's more.
Laying low.
Let's go this way first. I want to see what this thing is. Oh, the stairs down already? Potion of Major Endurance. Right. Two of those Taandra Terra things. Hold on a second. Wizard's double. Can I? I can't just pick up one. Yeah, we do that then. Not really worth much, is it? Let's give him one. Okay, so this. Huh, stairs down already. Interesting. This is a small level, huh? If this is like a half hour, I'm gonna have to do the next level, guys, just to make this into a nice, you know, anniversary video. Sounded funny. Let me just make sure we're all arranged. One of us has our fist.
Hmm.
I got that one. Wow, that's a lot. That's a big crystal eater too. Well, I feel happy knowing that we can camp if we need to. Hold up, what happened? I'm gonna make short work of this. Ah! I killed that rock! Oh, I think we got Kana. Soul Shock. I haven't used that for a long time. Let's just throw out a blessing. Kana.
That's it.
That's it.
Grave does philosophy.
Yes. And that literally is it. Rope-like strands of webbing glisten with moisture.
I shall be discreet.
Well, you will not be discreet alone.
No problem.
Okay, so this is a little dead end. Dead endo. To Taandra Tara. Aha.
Something over there.
Something over there, I was about to say. Ancient crumbling bones are all that remain of countless victims. As well as Adrin's Wrecker. It's a unique arbalest. I don't use these in combats because, I mean, they're very slow like that. I mean, I thought arbalests were one of the type that you'd put on top of castle walls up on parapets and stuff. Now I know I'm not confusing it with catapults, or I forget the name of the other one. Arbalest or one of them. Attacks can stun on crits. It's a superb weapon, so it's plus 12 accuracy and plus 45% damage. This thing's actually 32 to 46 pierce versus deflection. Crits can inflict prone. -0.3 to crit damage multiplier. Hope it gets multiplied a lot, just to make a difference. Adrin's wrecker was known to many, even when Adrin himself was known to few. A rogue and expert markswoman, she fought in the War of Defiance and felled Adirin soldiers from the shadows. Impressive. She once told a people that she'd rather shoot an enemy in the back than give him the opportunity to strike back. Her patience was even more famous than her aim. She was reputed to have hidden in a tree for 3 days straight while she waited for an Adirin general to pass along the road to Madsdam. Her skill was such that none were able to confirm the tale. Interesting. It'd be interesting if it gets, like, randomly stuck in these webs. Interesting in a pain-in-the-ass kind of way. Wow, so we've really... Where's this key? Right, we haven't found a key. What are we missing here? All these levels have been pretty much self-contained. Am I supposed to get the key from the next level down? Or farther? Look, I'm eager to deal with that wailing thing. Oh god, shut your mouth. Let me just take another quick look. God, this is less than a half hour. We're done with the level. I mean, normally we'd find it. But we did miss something on the first pass. Around on the... You know, was it the last floor or the one before? I don't even know. Okay. Wow. Quickest level ever, either. I mean, ever. I mean, we're just about done here, but you see how the scale is different. It's taking up the whole screen, but the scale is different. I mean, these really aren't big chambers, but they take up large sections of the map, so I'm talking about. Alright, guys, I know I said just one level, but going down to 10. See if we can find that key, and whatever else lies in store. I can't see. What's that sound? Hear that? Thing's coughing. Hear some Robitussin or something, buddy? What the hell is this? Oh, there's the master staircase there. Okay, so after it's another. Look at how huge the perspective, the scale here. Just from the room, the spot that we're in, we already know a fourth of the map. We haven't moved. And look, let's go see who's got a coughing, like, asthma problem over here. Oh, a Sporling? Do they make those sounds? I don't remember them making those sounds. Didn't even bother.
Yes?
I'm ready.
What?
Hey.
Yeah. We all have range right now. Dank spores.
Sure.
What we got here? Dead adventurer. Okay, more camping supplies. Awesome. A brigandine. And 1509 copper. The luminous mushrooms give off a heavy, earthy musk. Menpogra. And a disease pudding? Oh, brother. Attack! Oh, he summoned a forest lurker. You jerk.
That's it.
Just stand there and let us kill you. Is it getting ready to do something? I'd love to finish the thing off. See it ass right in front, unfortunately. Yeah, that's not how I really want to be set up. Like, that's blocking the other characters. Alright, forget about your fist. Go back to that. Hit that. I'm not gonna be able to get through, so. That. I'd say just hit it. Maybe it won't hit Aloth, I don't know. I'd like to have. Well, that's Durance. Okay, let me just do that. Yeah, Aloth. Looks like it's gonna attack Theodas, so. Chain lightning for Aloth. We can reach from there. From where he is.
Lavaru, be on seek!
Alright, next. I want to finish off the Manpower thing. Can we...
How may I help?
Oh, you're running that way. Crap. I want... No. let's see if she gets a chance to get the disease pudding here. Pretty fast spell. Maybe a dare can get through. Oh, don't bother with that. I don't know if he can. Oh, we can. Good. What's disengaging? Oh no. We gotta get him out of here. Can he move back a little? He's stuck. These guys are attacking, right? Knocked down. Now we can get through. At least most of us. Still stuck. So we can't get through. Durance, can you move over there? That way maybe we can get through? No. Okay. Give him the... Frustrating. Oh. We could summon a Drake. We'll probably be done though.
Following you.
Oh. Good, because there's more... The shades and stuff. Mm. Now we have to run back the other way.
Following your lead.
Is that thing attacking? Attack that. Thank you. Oh. Gon's pledge. Jeez, Aloth. I can't heal him because it's his overall health. Dare. The dare is here.
Eh?
Oh my god, it did that again. Alright, attack the shadow.
Should have been there, Allah.
Oh, does she actually get to go? Holy crap. What can she not get through again? God. Must rest. Potions of minor endurance. Don't need that. 36 silver. 203 copper.
No problem.
Don't leave him. Is that Aloth? I think it was. Might have been a dare. I think it was Aloth. Alright, we gotta rest. Okay. Sorry about that. My ear is itchy. Yeah, I'm glad we found those two camping things. Camping supplies. That was great.
My eyes are peeled.
Yeah, keep on the eye out for a key. The luminous mushrooms give off a heavy, earthy musk. That they tend to do. Ooh, what's this? That looks dangerous. Pass through that, I guess? Looks like something we can pass through to get to the other side. Kind of like what was in the, crap. Galloway's Maw? Where you had to fight the, well, hunt down the bear and or tiger. Back off of, Twin Elms. Old song? Yeah. A winding mass of vicious thorns and thick vines spans the gap between the cavern walls. There are spaces here and there in the vegetation you can see into the chamber beyond, but it will be difficult to pass through unscathed. Look at the vines. Ooh. The vines have grown so thick and tangled as to form a nearly impenetrable wall. Many of the thorns are as long as the span of your palm. From time to time you hear the faintest creak as if something has shifted slightly within the mass. Cut away at the vegetation with a weapon. You deal a sturdy blow to the nearest vine and get little result. These vines seem unnaturally resistant. No amount of hacking, smashing, or cutting seems to have much effect. It would take far too long to cut away all of them. Cross the wall? Yep. Is this like word for word? I'm not even sure. The moment you start to step through, the entire wall gives a great heave, coming alive in a surging mass of branches and vines. Thick, thorny branches swing towards you with vindictive force. You're being very vindictive there, branches.
It's all
always Durance getting hurt. Despite your best efforts to avoid them, Durance gets hit in the head by one of the vines. The plants seem to react to their victory thrashing all the more vigorously. Okay, so they're partying down. Scythe-like barbs tear and scrape at you as you pass, surrounding you in a hailstorm of scratching, thrashing plants. With one final great effort, you scrabble clear of the vines, stumbling out into the space beyond the wall and out of reach. You're right there, Durance? It stares down. And that's the master staircase, right? Okay.
Nice and quiet.
Oh, hello. Swamp spore, menpogra, swamp spore, forest lurker, giant dank spore, and a forest lurker. And a partridge in a pear tree. Right. Well, I see no reason to mess around with weapons. Ranged weapons. I don't know if we can knock these things over, but we'll try. Combat hasn't officially started yet. I hate those spore things, so we'll try to take those out. Chain lightning and disintegration. Now we can do that.
Following your lead.
We're disengaging, just running over to them. I gotta shield him. Cast your spell, Theodas. Oh boy. What's going on there, Theodas? Alright, cast on this thing then. Oh, that's evil Durance. Okay, hit that thing. Oh, he turned. Okana just turned back. Palagina and Canna. Well, I can't heal him. I can't heal Palagina, she's evil. At least I don't think it works that way. Okay, she is out of focus, so hit that thing. Who has it? Suppress affliction. Where is he? There, in the thick of it. I don't know why we're disengaging like that. That one's close to death. Heal her. Did he go? Because you got another healing to do. Alright, lay on hands. She's not doing it yet, so... heal her. Is she too far away? Oh, she... Durance! Heal her or run over to her. And then... heal her. What the hell? Mr. Durance. He's stuck. Okay, that would explain it, I guess. And she's too far away. Alright, so he can't revive her. Adair is turn evil. Can you reach... with that? I guess not, because you're not doing crap. The Men Pogo is almost dead.
Following your lead.
That's it!
What did he cast? Why does it show up like that? Okay, Kanna needs help now. Disintegrate this friggin' thing. I just want to get rid of it. All the crap here.
What?
Oh
God. All those missiles right up here. Well, this doesn't have a butt, does it? Whatever you have. Kanna is good. Attack that. Got one more knockdown, too. I don't know if it works on them, but.
How bad?
Oh, Kanna! Pause. Wait. Oh, he turned evil. Oh, what? Oh, he turned evil, and he's using this. Who do we have that we can... Oh my god, I got Durance too. So the only one not evil right now. They should surround these portraits so you can see easier. It's Theodas. Or evil and standing. Theodas and Aloth. And we don't have anything we can... Yeah. Getting tough. Getting tough. Keep hitting. Aloth, keep your stuff up.
Yeah.
Oh, jeez. Kill it. Kill the frickin' thing. Ah! Now she's turned evil. Destroy it. Thank you. Kanna's good again. Barely injured. Is anyone else good right now? Durance is back. Now we're doing okay. Cast that. Did she turn evil? She's evil, I think. Okay.
Following your
lead. Beyond seek.
Oh, he keeps switching back to his to that weapon. Boom, get him. And there. Is she back? Disintegrate, ignite or whatever. Soul ignition.
That's it.
Oh, Adair's back. Okay. I think we might all be back. Settle in at your places. No, don't. Go right there. Just stand there. Right there. Hit it. You can't reach it from there. Oh, it was fun. Now we get to hear these bursts over and over again. Oh, a ring of thorns? Plus 3 dexterity and plus 5 reflex, plus 20 defense while stunned and prone. This loop of tiny interwoven vines is studded with blackened thorns. It fits easily around your finger. Well, which one is putting it on the finger? I wonder if you have anything like this. So this is what? Dexterity and reflex. Don't I get to use... No, I think it's 1 and 2 we get to use. First and third level. No, first and second level spells we get to use per encounter. 3, I don't think so, so I'm gonna save that. My deflection. Unshackling. Oh, he has suppressed deflection, right? Okay. Overseeing. Plus 5 will, plus 10 stunned and prone. This is dexterity reflex, stunned and prone. Unshackling. Oh, she has that? Okay. I thought that was one of her abilities, actually. She has it in the ring. Overseeing. Fortitude, reflex, will. I'm not gonna keep it. You have other cool stuff like it.
Light. Flame and sound. We'll keep to ourselves.
Oh, apparently we continue on that way. Oop, trap detected. Well, we're not gonna go this way
now
yet.
This I haven't seen before.
Not yet. Bunch of dank spores. Oh, a trap.
Hmm?
Hmm? Trap.
That's settled.
Sure is. Ooh, Verena's leaves. White leaf. One silver. It's a rapier. Plus 5 accuracy. And a superb weapon, so plus 12 accuracy, plus 45% damage. Plus 20% damage against prone, stunned, and flanked enemies. A Red Saren fairy tale tells of a blacksmith who was traveling through the woods on his way home from a distant village. The wheel of his wagon broke, and he had to make camp and repair it. During the night, a pack of hunting Stelgars ventured into his encampment, and he hid among the trees. Just as one of the beasts picked up his scent, a Dilemkin stepped out of the copse and in front of the blacksmith. The Stelgar soon lost interest, and when the blacksmith had recovered from his terror, he thanked the Dilemkin, Verena, and begged to know how she could express his gratitude. Thrice she bade him forget about her and continue on his way, but seeing the man's zeal, she finally relented. "Enemies encroach on my wood," she said. "Bring me a means of defending it." The blacksmith swore that he'd return with a worthy gift, and so departed it. Weeks later, he forged a dagger and sought her in the forest. She saw the gift and smiled sadly. "A noble attempt, yet I fear it would do little to clear the foes that spring up in my midst. Please return home and know that you have my thanks for your efforts." But the blacksmith shook his head and, over her protest, promised to bring her a suitable gift. After months behind the forge, he'd crafted several fine battle axes, and he brought the best of these to Vierna. Even her graciousness did not conceal the horror on her face. "Surely my enemies would seize this and turn it against me and my forest. Please go to your village and forget about this." But, deaf to her objections, he vowed to return again. He vowed to try again. So the blacksmith devoted a year to crafting the finest, sharpest spearheads any had seen. People came from near and far to purchase his very weapons he had crafted, finished, and deemed unworthy of Vierna. And as his reputation grew, so did the village around him. After a year of labor, he returned to the forest with the finest spear any had ever seen. The wild seemed to have dwindled, and finding her was no easy task. When he eventually did, he presented the spear. "A weapon worthy of you," he said, "long enough that none may snatch it from your grasp." But she recoiled from the wooden pole. "I could not defend myself with the bones of my own felled trees." I beg you, go and do not return." Yet he made an oath to bring her a final gift to fit her purposes. After years of work, he crafted the finest rapier in the land, its blade as narrow and fine as a needled leaf. In that time, the sale of his lesser attempts had made him a wealthy man, and his village had grown to a small city. When he returned to the forest a final time, he hardly recognized it. The sprawling woodlands had been whittled to a few scrubby thickets, and Vierna was nowhere to be found. He returned once again to his forge and spent the rest of his days making rapiers to wreak vengeance upon Vierna's unknown tormentors. Wow, what a sad story. Now, is someone still using a rapier? I think Adair was, but no longer. Yeah. Hate to just, you know, sell these things off, but
slowly now.
It's only the very odd thing that we end up being able to use. Hide armor and Tundra Terra. Oh, because so we continue around this way, and I guess that's the whole dungeon. Wow. 2 levels? Where's this key? How far down? What? Don't hit it. God, we're getting close here.
Hmm? That's settled.
No problem.
Heavy earthy musk.
Now this I haven't seen before. That's settled.
That's
no
settled.
Problem.
Ah. Oh, we haven't been up in this area, that's right.
Let's go!
Oh, we have melee weapons out. Alright. Or one of us does. Two of us.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
Come one, come all. Actually, let her hit this one. Kill that one. She turned evil. Damn it.
Hey.
That's it!
She turned evil again? Damn it. Keep them fireballs going. Toast these things. Make them all nice, warm, and toasty. Cast that? Oh yeah, I guess he did. I didn't even see it. You're good again? Start hitting things. Healing time. Oh, he turned evil? Kinda turned evil.
Still three.
Kinda empty at us.
Moet. Ixi. Anna. Anna.
Press affliction. Didn't work. Damn it. Stop running all over the frickin' place, too.
I'm ready.
Sombreros, se-
Sombrero.
Lavaru, be on seek!
Sit!
Oh, you know what's going on, Fowley? When they get taken over, they keep switching back to... Yeah. Cut that out.
Hi?
Finally. Oh, we're back? Alright, let's kill this thing. Oh, because we switched.
Following you.
That's it.
Okay.
Lavaru, be on seek.
Tough battle. Next. Actually, everybody at the Well, he looks creepy walking around like that.
Come back.
Lavaru, be on...
Giving you all the magic I got.
Lavaru, be on...
Too evil. Okay. Turn back to good. Get your thing out. Sword. Well, if we get a little closer. Oh, hey. More turning evils. Get those two. Like that. Is she evil now? Yeah, she must be evil. Yep.
How may I help?
He glitched and then he went. He might hit him with the ring. Oh, he turned evil.
Yeah.
However you can hit him.
Lost your lead.
I don't think we can knock him down, but try. Yay! Trying to glitch through, huh? What is this? Mouse server's not working. Ooh. Kakadob's Hazel? It's a unique wand, two-handed wand. 14 to 22 Pierce Crush, exceptional weapon, plus 8 accuracy, plus 30% damage, plus 10 accuracy granted to an ally attacking the same target, grants jolting touch on critical hit one per encounter. Kagadab, I don't know how to say that, was a wizard and wand maker. Though brilliant, he had trouble selling his work due to a number of eccentricities, not the least of which was a vow that he would never make two wands of the same color. The Hazel Wand was one of his most powerful creations. Unfortunately, like everything he made, it was the only one of its kind. Giving him these traps. Oh, just got bow out.
Eh? Eh?
I? Hey.
What?
I'm ready.
Following your lead.
Okay, make sure everyone's on the same page now. Does more damage. Exceptional. This is an exceptional weapon. Better accuracy, better damage. Plus 10 accuracy. I like it. I do like it. I'm afraid we're done with the Ingrithin Scepter. We've had that for a long time. Look at that. He's just holding a tree branch. Alright. Yeah, let's see. See what we can do to enchant. Enchanting requirement. So you have to go up a level in enchanting. I just don't know how to do that. Maybe I have to start making potions and stuff, and then we'll go up. Don't know. In any case, Shocking Lash. Maximum enchantment value reached. Okay. Alright, what do we got in here? Where? Oh, right there?
Quickly and quietly.
Ooh, a diamond. I think this is only our second diamond we found, maybe?
Sure.
Anything else? We looked at him, right? That's where we found the... No, actually, we didn't. 501 copper and another potion of major endurance. Awesome. actually. Kinda could use another. Oh, didn't mean to hit that. The map. All right, we're done. That goes down to level 12, obviously. And this is the master staircase, this one here. Let's go right up to Cadnua. Hireling payday. We have a prestigious visitor. I wonder if we can find him here. Hold up, actually. Checking. Alright, so far everything is good. We don't have to do anything over again. A day and 4 hours, our chapel will be done. So, off screen, I will sell stuff, buy camping supplies, rest up, and we'll bring one of our party members with us. Harabius. Go to find a druid in Twin Elms. Grieving mother. Not sure what to do with her. That's that we're not doing. This is for Sagani. I found this. Opposite side is Twin Elms. Okay, so we got two we can do. For Harabius and Sagani in this Bale Lake. I think it's in Elmshore. I would have found something else. So I'll be heading back that way to help our companions. And yeah, that's what lies in store for episode 201. What a long game this is. Very awesome though. Thanks for watching and see you next time. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.